All right, guys, coming at you with some epic Blitz action today. It's the 1st of July, which means we're debuting a new month. Oh, well, we are debuting a new month, but more specifically, we are debuting a new map. We got the July Blitz World Series event coming up. We got 7 divisions. We're also running free-for-all and team games in the tournament this month, so lots of action coming at you. Here is the tournament month for the 1v1s. So it's called Brute. Now, you got a genetic mutator in the middle of the map. This genetic mutator cannot be destroyed. It cannot be built off of. But most importantly, it doesn't take any power. So you can capture it pretty early on. In the past, we had the Psychic Dominator, but it took power, so you couldn't really, it was kind of hard to do. We also have some paradrops up in the top corners. The paradrops auto-capture. Navy can be built in either harbor, left or right. The tunnels do nothing except look cool. Keep in mind, there's also 3 buildings to be fortified, a hut and 2 tents. I think the map you guys can see here, this area, building area is pretty small primarily. You cannot base walk through the bottom. You can't base walk through here or here. Theoretically, you could base walk through this or maybe down this. Some wacky stuff up here. Should see some interesting action though. It's a very open map. I tried to have a very aggressive open map last month. And it ended up creating bottlenecks, and it was kind of a more allied-favored, kind of turtle-friendly map in some ways. So this month, you know, this is very difficult. Like, how do you turtle against this, right? I mean, your base is basically one big opening. So, should see some different action. You know, that's what it's all about month to month. I try to kind of switch things up. That's the idea here. So I think this map should give us some fun, interesting looks. The paradrops are kind of funny because... if you don't have the genetic mutator, it's kind of a liability, but it also forces people to get some infantry on the map early, which should add some fun to the game, I think. So, that's it, the Brute map. Gator Spader with the sub. My guy, thank you, I appreciate it. Oh my god, the Connie paradrop on the back right. That's hilarious. Yeah, when you're playing Soviet, you don't expect the paradrop. We got Zane in red fighting out of Pakistan on the right. We got Osama in yellow fighting out of Egypt on the left. Zane, I was looking for games and I said, Zane, you know, who do you want to play or whatever? And he's like, let me get Osama. He's been talking some smack. So I think these guys have been going at each other a little bit. Should be interesting. Zane, kind of an OG Blitz player. He did win the Kong tournament. What was that, October or something? One of the first Blitz events. So since then, though, he hasn't really played much. He took the last few months kind of off. Of Blitz, so he hasn't been around as much, but obviously he's a top level player. Osama's a great top level player as well, and Osama has been playing more Blitz, so it should be pretty interesting here. It's gonna be interesting the way that players build their oils to try to keep them out of harm's way. Like, this is pretty risky, right? Being right near this cliff is kind of scary for Zane. Neither player using this top plateau, which I think should be done. I think that's kind of the point of the map anyway, so hopefully people figure that out. All right, So far, so good. Both players baiting around a little bit. Oh, we got Zane pushing some... Oh, he's pulling his Connie's back here. So Death's on the top side. So Zane with nice map control here. I'm playing off that higher ground, looking for targets. I like it. Let's see if this button works. This should show you guys... Oh, that's not the right button. I was going to show you guys the dates for the tournament this month. Okay, so now... Conscripts... Oh, yes, nice. Okay, so Zane... Yeah, so Zane with map control here, I think, should be looking to try to get the Psychic Dominator. Or... Genetic Mutator, sorry. I'm gonna mess that up a lot. Yeah, I think, you know, if you have map control, get in there, grab the Genetic Mutator if you're the one who's has the tanks out front. Oh, the drone's gonna take that Engineer and the Deso. Beautiful drone from Osama. And gets a tank. Damn, that Deso just... Or that drone just went off. All right, so now we got a Kirov coming. We'll see how quick Zane can counter. Osama quite a bit ahead here on tech, huh? He's already out with his Iron Curtain and Kirov. Using that, Kirov tried to do some damage on the army. Pretty good move. It's not going to make it to the base anyway. Whoa! Those Desos got way too far in. Zane doing a decent job avoiding them. But yeah, it does allow that Kirov to grab a War Factory. So that's pretty good value for Osama. Yeah, Osama's gonna be pretty happy. That Deso did a good job pushing those tanks out of position. He kept Zane from getting the genetic mutator that he wanted. Definitely bruised some of those tanks. Yeah, good value for sure. Haha, Gator Glad, man, that's what the train commutes are all about. We were talking about the other day. We'll know that RA2 has made it to the moon when you're on the train and there's like a big Blitz game and everyone on the train's watching it. That's the goal. That's where we'll be. Give me like 7 years. and everyone on your train will be watching it together. More drones now from Osama. Zane's got to be getting a little frustrated with how effective those are being. But now look at Osama's playing this map. Osama's playing this map very, very well here. So now a Dreadnought out. That Dreadnought's going to start doing some work here on the bottom. Zane needs to be very careful. I'm not sure if Zane sees this Dreadnought. Zane should try to hop down and try to counter this Dreadnought from the land. But ooh, iron. So Zane does get him to blow that Iron Curtain a little bit early. So now Zane with a lot of room to run for his tanks. So, ooh, Zane, nice split here. He needs to go shoot that Dreadnought on the bottom side, but he has a lot to be doing right now. He now has three groups of tanks he's trying to micro, but that IC coming in, going to be devastating. Oh, he tries to go for that oil, doesn't get it, does get it, but Zane is able to sell the battle lab first. Nice push here, and you got to imagine Soviet versus Soviet on this map with it being so open. The first Iron Curtain is going to be pretty devastating here. Okay, and this Dreadnought still on the bottom now, AFK, but so Zane's not a Zane. Well, he needs to take out this Dreadnought as soon as possible. I mean, he just needs to send a couple tanks and get it done. Flag Track's not now countering. Zane looking for some value, trying to counterpunch here. Oh, the conscripts on the backside for Zane doing some work. I like that. Let's go, boys. Wow, banging out in the center here. So Zane's pumping the conscripts up the center. Zane now low power. All right, so now Zane has some... this is glitching. Okay, sorry. God, it's hard to follow. Oh my God, the conscripts on the backside are still doing work. But Osama just overwhelming with the rhinos on the right side. So there's a little glitch on the bottom there, those rocks. So Zane's going allied for us, mixing things up, letting these guys pick their own factions. So that was interesting. You know, someone mentioned this to me and I forgot to check it. The subs have to have a straight line to shoot their torpedoes. So we got to remove some of these rocks. Oh, that's why we're testing the new map out. Yeah, we'll get some background music going here. I turned the background music off for the bigger games with the non-stop commentary. With these guys, I'm kind of chilling, so we have some music. All right, so now Zane's gonna bring a GI rush. So Zane does take that forward tent. That's very frustrating. You definitely want to get your opponents. You definitely want to get your tents before your opponent gets them. That's very, very annoying. Zed, I can message you. These ways looking smaller than I thought. What ways? All right. So the GI is not able to get much done. Now Osama coming in early with some rhinos here. And Zane, oh my God, did Zane go three oils before War Factory? Very scary against the Soviet players. Now he has to bring those GIs back to try to defend. GIs back to defend now. Yeah, so they get in, take that power plant. So, I mean, Zane's gonna have a very nice economy here. He's got those three early oils. Yeah, so you can build off the top. See, so Zane is building up on the top side. The choke point's looking smaller. Okay, para drop backside for Zane. Not able to get much done. The double para for Allied, I think, it's kind of nice on this map just because this map is so exposing for the Allied player. It's kind of nice to give him that. Oh, he goes low power. He puts the Prism Tower, but goes low power. So now the Grizzlies have to try to target the conscripts. The Rhinos, very, very tough here. And most maps are like that, to be fair, in Blitz. The Allies can be difficult early game for someone who doesn't play it a ton. And I think this map is definitely going to be the case. Yeah, I mean, we're still experimenting a little bit. You know, I could bring this feature in one cell on either side. That would make this one cell bigger. Like, we could shrink this just a little bit. Yeah, you definitely need to build up on the airport. You definitely have to use both because this area is pretty small. All right, so yeah, hey, Zane makes it through that first one. That early didn't get too much done. He did take out a little bit off his expansion, but the airport's still standing on the top, which is nice. Similar to Doom, you know, if you lose your oil on the top cliff, it's going to be difficult to build up to it. Okay. Yeah, and so Zane now out with a lot of Grizzlies. Now it has his Eagles in the fight. Some snipers to help counter the fodder. No, the airport's not indestructible. No. All right, and nice. So Zane hits that oil. Now gonna run. Yeah, doesn't want to push in too much here. Falls back to a prism tower. Nice defense. Paradrop defensive from Zane. Zane, both players now bottoming out a little bit, especially players who've been playing the Yin Yang map. It will take a little bit this month to get used to the new economy. Obviously, last month, starting players off with those two oils, it kind of spoiled everyone a little bit, you know? So now this month, we're going to have, you know, you're back to your regular builds and stuff, which are obviously a little bit slower. But, I mean, it does change. Like, you still see early aggression in the game. It's just less units in that aggression, whereas you could afford to build a couple war factories right away before. Now obviously you have to get your oils out first. All right, so the 4 minute mark here. So Zane going topside, coming around, hits this oil, doesn't get that oil. Eagles coming in, so takes the battle lab. That's very nice. That's what as we move into the mid game here, if the allied player can control the Soviet player's tech, that's obviously exactly what he needs to do. Did pay a few Eagles for that, and that's, and Osama at the same time, that's exactly what Osama needs to do. When those Eagles come in, Osama needs to shoot all of them down. Yeah, you gotta kill, yeah, Legend, what? No, these are friendly brutes, Legend. These are buddy brutes, we call these buddy brutes. You gotta kill the brutes first, Legend. You're a pro, you can kill the brutes. Legend can't handle six brutes. All right, so sniper out. That's a lot of rhinos, and neither player able to get the genetic mutator. Ooh, nice hit from Zane, using those eagles very nicely there, and he gets them all home. Yeah, that's exactly, I mean, Osama, you get a hit like that, it's devastating on its own. If you don't take the eagles down, it's terrible, because how long does it take? Does anyone know how long does it take for eagles to recharge? All right, so Osama's gonna push here. If Zane can hold this, he should be able to win the game, but this is quite a few units here, and he's still pumping Grizzlies. Zane doesn't really have the money to switch over to tech tanks. He'd love to get his Mirages out, but he's not gonna be able to. And Zane, oh my God, big hit there. Yeah, and so now Zane has to go for a base trade. Zane still has eight Eagles though. If Zane can, this is very interesting. Zane's in a very interesting spot here. If he can somehow, he needs to get his Eagles in, so Eagles are gonna come. He has to take the MCV out. Oh, he doesn't have any tanks left. He's not able to defend himself anyway. That was nice distraction. Zane did a good job like distracting Osama, but I don't think he can hold here though. And what did the Eagles just do? Because I know they didn't go hit this oil, which they should have done. Oh, the Iron Curtain, and he's got an Iron Curtain out too. He needs to hit this oil, get the MCV. He's got to start doing a lot. Well, maybe he should use the Eagles defensively, though. This is hard. I'm not sure. Oh, he's got quite a few Rockies now. Yeah, he has to try to avoid these flaks, obviously. Oh, Zane on 20K. Just throw the Eagles. Who cares? Oh, the force shield comes. That cancels the time on the... Wow, nice micro, though, from Zane. Didn't lose many Eagles there. Cancels the timer on the IC, which is nice. The brutes, I think so. Maybe you could run an engineer, like, if you micro right down the center. Maybe, I don't know. Shut up. All right, and now the Rocky's coming from the bottom side, but there is a flak cannon right there. These are flak tracks. He's got two elite flak tracks in that group. Very scary. Zane doing a good job keeping the pressure. There was a point in this game where if you would have sent me a snapshot, I would have said it was 80% winning for Osama right after his initial attack. He was so far up on rhinos. Zane, I haven't seen Zane in a while. Zane's a smart player. It's been a very interesting game for Zane. So the brute map, I made a 3v3 version where there's hills down the middle, so Ed can't base walk, and then I made the starting positions in the corner, and so we're gonna do some team games and stuff. And yeah, anyway, I got all day, man. I'm on all day, Ed, so we'll get you some games. I think we might get you a couple points with MZIN. I think MZIN's around. Or would Saw and Fish be better? I feel like Saw and MZIN would be pretty close. Well, the pink lines are for the pink lines are for the cliff, right? Oh, but wait, so Kane, with buggy pathing, would that, I wonder if it's the tunnels. Okay, all right, allied versus allied now. Osama out with the early Eagles, Zane out with the early anti-air. So Zane going War Factory first here. GGI IFE is definitely the way to counter the early Eagles. Osama, I think, is probably a little used to that last map with the economic kickstart. A complete aerial opening with no oils to start is very, very difficult. It's very expensive, and your units are very fragile. And if you don't get immense value out of each unit, it's very difficult, especially if your opponent goes War Factory early. Ah, interesting. I bet it's the tunnels messing it up. I'll show you, Kane. I'll open the map editor after this. Well, first we need to confirm that this is actually an issue, because Osama threw that last point. So the only person who's complained so far is someone who threw a point. Zane's looking tough. But look at this. Osama's got these paradrop on the back right. I love these early paradrops. We're getting some funny action here. Alting the War Factory here, but that paradrop, the paradrop from Osama's going to do work. Yeah, that oil's going to go down. Should take two power plants with it. Yeah, it takes two power plants with it. Yeah, Kane, fish. There is actually a way to make tunnels work, though, in Red Alert 2, but they have to move in a straight line. So we could put a tunnel here, and you could, like, enter this tunnel and come out here, but it's, like, super buggy. We don't really know why the mechanic exists. It's definitely not made for player versus player, although theoretically it could work. Yeah, Kane, join after this. Password 99. Wait, who won the last point? It's not 1-1. Is it 1-1? That's not right. The scoreboard's not right. You guys are sleeping in the chat. I'm sleeping in the booth. You guys are sleeping in the chat. It's 2-1, right? Someone must know. Elite Sniper? Nice. Is it 1-1, Zap?
Yeah. Not exactly sure what the idea was there.
I was confused. I deserved that. Thank you, Legend. Oh, this is the third game. Okay, we're killing it. We're crushing it. Love that. All right. Yeah, nice little allied versus allied action here. The AFC wars. Zane has really nice Eagle macro. Does Zane play a lot with allied? I think of Zane as a Soviet player. I guess I just think of every, like, top player as a Soviet player. This is not a barn burner. It's best of five. Artie with the premature barn burners. That's classic Artie. Look at these. The IFV army, very diverse. The creators of Red Alert 2 would love this. Like, can you imagine when they were sitting around getting wasted and they came up with the idea for the IFV? They're like, well, Soviet has better units, stronger units. Like, we'll just make Soviet, like, rock and roll, like, boom, boom, boom. And then we'll make Allied, like, jazz. You know, you got these IFVs, you put different stuff in them, they become different things. Of course, no one actually uses that mechanic, but right now, Zane is using it, and I think the creators of the game would be very, very happy. And then we'll make Allied terrible. Well, I think it's my favorite part is, like, people that say, like, we shouldn't change the game. Like, it's, like, hilarious. Like, I mean, games change all the, like, games always change. I mean, like Major League Baseball. Oh, nice little push here. I like this from Zane. Wow. Zane takes that one home. Another very nice play by Zane. Yeah, I mean, so, like, every sport, like, I mean, like, the NBA, the NFL, I mean, I'm using American sports, those are the ones I know, they change, like, the rules update every year. They're not big things, you know, like, they're not changing massive things, but, like, in baseball, it became very common, like, if you have a hitter, and he always hits to one spot, you pull your fielders and you go stack the fielders in that spot. They started doing that in Major League Baseball. It's very effective. So next year, they're saying they can't do that. You literally can't shift players anymore, which is, like, a crazy rule. I mean, to tell players, like, you don't get to choose where you stand, that's like a massive decision to make. But that's, I mean, the games are evolving all the time. I mean, I think it was 500 years before they decided the pawn should be able to move two spaces. All right. Anyway, I'm just on a little rant, but the point is, though, is the idea that, like, games, the problem is we don't have the developers here anymore. So I would assume the developers would be like, hey, the IFVs weren't as cool as we thought. Maybe we should give them a little boost, but maybe not. To be fair, at the top level, I mean, Allied hangs with Soviet with the right players. Yeah, when I used to play World of Warcraft, what, every other Tuesday, right? Every other Tuesday, you would have to upload. It would just be, like, all of the changes, all of the nerfs, all of the buffs. Now, this isn't an argument to say that the game that Blitz makes, that Blitz is like a new version. Like, Blitz is a completely different game. Like, I'm not proposing changes this dramatic. I'm just saying, like, the ideas of little buffs and nerfs, I think, are a very common part of game design. Bringing down the value of the brute from the genetic mutator. You'll have to look at that. So, okay, so with the RA2 ladder versus the YR ladder, do you see more Soviet in one of them, or more Allied in one of them? Like, is Allied more viable in Yuri's Revenge? Both players going Allied versus Allied here again. Yeah, that's the problem, though, is the problem without an official company, you know, running. It's really hard, you know. It's very difficult because, like, in World of Warcraft, I wasn't in the Discord with the people making the changes. I couldn't even complain if I wanted to. It was just like, yo, here's the new shit, deal with it. And so it's really difficult, like, in a situation like this where you have, like, it's much more like, you know, we don't have an official person. It just makes it hard. It makes it a lot more difficult to do things. So the weird thing is, Artie, is that Frank says the opposite of that. All right, Osama pushing in now. Grizzly's topside. Yeah, if you're going to build up there, you got to defend it. And it's pretty difficult, right? Spreading yourself out that early. But I do think spreading your oils up on that cliff is going to be a pretty good option. So is it the, is it the tunnels or what cliff is it? Yeah, and so Osama coming in with the Grizzlies now. Nice Grizzly advantage. Zane trying to get his GIs in position to defend here. So now Zane decides to try to do a base trade, but he's got a couple Rockies and a couple IFVs. I don't think that's going to work. But these GIs with this Prism Tower should be able to hold. Oh, and that tent doing work on the retreat. Oh, he tries. And again, I like this from Zane kind of feigning these attacks to throw Osama off of his attack. It's very nice. Osama could have kept picking around this base. These GIs obviously very immobile. Immobile? Is that a word? Oh, look at that brute. That tank got lost and got beat up by a brute. That's hilarious. AFC goes down. So Osama definitely in the driver's seat right now. Let's see if he can keep the pressure on. Keep Zane from coming back here. Zane with a couple, three Prism Towers now from Zane. Still a pretty nice economy, though. Four oils. Zane has no tanks, though. You definitely want to have tanks. Tanks are important. Zane losing a few Rockies here. Oh, nice, Kane. So you don't think it's the tunnels? We can keep the tunnels? We can keep the tunnels? Navy SEAL now from Osama. Yeah, maybe a winter map. It's hard. The problem is, so with maps that, like, so if you do a different map every game, you know, you can have a dark map, a light map, you can do whatever you want. It doesn't matter. With a map that I have to stare at for 50 hours a month, I have to have, like, really good contrast, really, like the lighting, everything has to be very, like, optimal. And the snow maps, like, when you stare at them nonstop for an entire month, it kind of burns your eyeballs, which is hard, but we'll get different themes eventually. Another nice para drop, get some damage done. I think throughout this month, we're definitely going to see players have to adjust with these para drops, right? I mean, like, there's going to be a lot of para drops, and players, I mean, if you're Allied, you almost have to have a sniper in the back of your base chilling. If you're Soviet, you're going to have a Desolator chilling. You just gotta be ready. Obviously, you gotta try to minimize the damage from these para drops. And Zane now bringing a counterpunch. And somehow Osama again behind. I swear, like, getting kind of distracted with thinking about map stuff. But I swear Osama keeps being, like, in winning positions. And then somehow Zane ends up winning all that full AFC pad going down. You saw Zane target the Eagles first. It's nice. You target those Eagles, get some nice promotions out of it. Now bringing some Eagles into the fight. A couple of elite GIs. Zane should be able to push in here and stomp him out. We do a para drop on the backside. Another para drop coming too. But can you see what I mean with the tunnel? The way that the tunnel doesn't connect the pink line. Snark said he didn't think it would be a problem though. But what's Snark know, right, guys? All right, so okay, so Osama does hold. Oh my God, so Osama's got to be looking to bring a little counterpunch here. And again, Zane with no tanks. Someone tell Zane he needs to build tanks. Zane, you really need to build. Why is Zane on 8K and his war factory is not doing anything? Zane, build tanks. Faraday AOE in the house.
I'm so excited you're here. I could punch a grizzly tank.
Someone really needs to do both players a favor and just go kill those brutes. All right, so the value of the brutes, the corner pieces on the map. Oh, welcome back to Blitz, Zane. That's the thing is, that's gonna happen. When you haven't played much Blitz, that's gonna happen. You're gonna get in the heat of the moment. You're gonna put Noel in a position like that. And then hopefully you learn your lesson. And Zane's gonna be like, oh yeah, that's why you don't build your oils like that. Massive, massive, massive. Kane, do you know how to lower the value of the brutes? The civilian brutes? Because I do not. Zane's still doing good, though. It is best of five. Zane can take this one home. This game has swung a couple times. Really good action here. And neither player taking the mutator. Kane, we're both useless, man. And so Zane, I like that from Osama, keeping Zane's AFC down. Very nice. Path in the house. Path's ready for the new map. Okay. And again, and I love this from Zane, as soon as he starts getting out tanked in a battle, he just goes and attacks. But for some reason, Osama falls for it. It's like, dude, Osama, you have so many units right now. Drop the hammer, buddy. Sniper's doing work, microing those IFBs nicely. He's got the mirages. Zane quits out, 2-2. Is the barn burning? Is the barn burning? Wait, 10 followers from 800. 10. Wait, Paf, what's that mean? All right. Here we go. Here we. Oh, 10 away from 800. Got it. Okay, I got you. All right, here we go. Match point, guys. Match point. The barn is officially burning here. It's 2-2. These guys have really been coming at each other. Put on a good show for us. A lot of back and forth. Good testing out of the map here. So that both players are choosing their own factions here. They're going allied versus allied. The double paradrops are getting a lot done. I think, you know, on this map, there's a couple things that the players are going to have to adjust to very quickly. One is, where are you going to put your oils to keep them safe, to avoid those massive chain reactions, which ultimately lost Zane that last game. Though I think he was a little bit behind anyway. So where are you going to put your oils? How are you going to protect them? And then, I don't know, I feel like the genetic mutator is a viable option. And then also you need to keep in mind on this map when to go Navy. You know, as soon as things get locked up, if you have the money for it, adjusting to the economy. Adjusting for the economy from last month, obviously starting with less oils, and then the double paradrops. The paradrops from both players, the double paradrops from Allied, both, you just have to have a solution early because there's just so many paradrops that are gonna happen in this game. You know, a lot of times in AVA, we have players canceling out each other's AFCs. They keep destroying each other's AFCs early game, and that cancels a lot of paradrops. But now, I mean, with this, even if you cancel an AFC, there's still another paradrop coming. So we're gonna see a lot of paradrops this month. Another viable option, though, I think Soviet versus Allied, would be to go over early with your Rhinos and try to take out the Allied player's paradrop, if possible. And so we see that from Zane now. He's got the sniper IFB out. Doing some work very early here. Okay. So Eagle's out now from Osama first. He's gonna hit that. Ooh, he gets the AFC and he's in and out clean. no anti-air from Zane to counter these eagles, but a paradrop the back of his base, back of Osama's base now for Zane. And I like that Zane goes topside, takes out, so grabs that airport. I think that's a nice, nice move. But Zane needs to be careful though. He is out tanked here, so he's gonna maybe get caught on his way home. So Osama pulls out, so Zane is able to hit that airport clean. But look at this paradrop in the bottom right. Where's that sniper IFB? All very sneaky paradrop from Osama. The Eagles come in as well, take that oil, but that was a nice oil build from Zane. So that oil did not chain react anything. Pretty rare in Blitz these days. Very nice. So he deals, so that was nice. That's great value. Zane got great value there. He's able to get home and resist the counterpunch. So still pretty even here. Zane brings out a second AFC. He's expecting Osama to come hit it. And Zane has no anti-air. Could that possibly be a full game strategy to go no anti-air? He hits one AFC, but Zane has another. Maybe Zane says, hey, anti-air is too expensive. I'm just going to buy. Oh, he just suicides that eagle. Oh, he hit. Wow. Okay, good job, Eagle. Right into the heart of five Rockies. All right, so Grizzly's pushing in now. So I will say the one thing, like, you know, there's a lot of, I don't want to mess too much with like individual player stat or unit stats in this game. The one thing I will say in Blitz, someday I would like to make it so Eagles can fight in the skies. Oh, nice hit. Takes the War Factory. That is Zane's only War Factory. So that's going to put him behind on Grizzlies, which is not good for Zane because he's already behind on Grizzlies. So now Osama sees the opening, brings the Rockies in, brings the Eagles. A lot of GIs getting some nice value here for Zane, but that's a lot of Grizzlies and a lot of, he doesn't have any anti-air. So these Rockies, there's no, okay, now one IFV. There's no anti-air now. These Rockies are uncontested. So he dives on the MCV and gets it. Zane tries to counterpunch with his own Eagles, doesn't get much out of it. Yeah, nothing left for Zane. It's gonna be it. Wow, what a series there. Osama takes that one home. Great, great, great games.